Hey, what's going on, Bully World? How you guys doing? This is Zeke, Bully Badass TV. Always a pleasure, always a pleasure. Quick note, the good folks over at BullySupplies.com have given Bully Badass TV, given us a coupon code, Bully Badass TV, all capital letters. Enter that into their coupon box and you will receive 15% off the total purchase of your items. So I think that's a great deal. You guys get a chance, go check out BullySupplies.com. All right. So today's video, this is basically a word of the day video, and the word for the day is culling. I'm going to give you guys a definition that I found on Wikipedia that I find is perfectly right, perfectly fine. Culling is a process of removing breeding animals from a group based on specific criteria. This is done either to reinforce certain desirable characteristics or to remove certain undesirable characteristics from the group. That's a very simple and clean, direct definition of the word cull. I think that, you know, culling is a practice when I speak to a lot of old school breeders or people who are serious about breeding that have been doing it for years. It's a term, it's an idea, it's a concept that they refer to quite a bit. Not many people in the American bully community really refer to the term of culling because, quite frankly, it's really not done. But culling is very, very important to, it's a very important concept in breeding. I mean, the idea is that when you breed animals, your goal is to produce better animals. When you put two dogs together, you put two cows together, not every animal is going to be a better product than its parents. And in those cases, those animals should be culled. Now, I'm not speaking on the terms of, you know, this isn't 1945 or 55 or 65. This is 2014. Culling doesn't necessarily have to mean what it meant. It doesn't have to be the loaded term that it was. It doesn't have to be the brutal practice that it was. Today, we can cull an animal simply by taking an animal down to the vet, getting it neutered, getting it spayed, and then placing that animal into a loving pet home. The reality of it is that not every animal should be bred. Just because it comes off of two beautiful parents doesn't mean that it should be bred. And I think that, you know, when you get to the science and the art of breeding, culling is a very important practice. It's very important. It's like when you're writing, you have to edit. You know, you write a paragraph. There's a thousand. You write a paper. There's a thousand words. You go back, you edit. You might lose 150 words. You know, it's just something that you have to do. That's how you refine and you make things better. And so culling, like I said, it doesn't have to be the brutal practice that it was, and it shouldn't be. It's 2014. If you're breeding, you should be culling. Take your animal, take the animals that aren't appropriate or don't fit your vision or don't fit the conformation, the standard set forth by the breed registry that you apply to, and have that animal fixed. It's just that simple. I think it's the professional thing to do as a breeder. I think it's the appropriate thing to do as a human being. That's my two cents. Peace.